Good morning, everyone. Yes, you didn't have my introduction, but let me also take the pleasure of introducing myself again. Girish Sharma. I work for Accenture, but I guess the part of the introduction that I want to give is that I've been associated in my roles, this one and the previous ones, about hiring talent for Accenture and the previous companies that I worked for. I think during the course of my journey in the last 8-10 years, it's been a privilege to become more aware on my focus that I would like to bring on to what was shared earlier in trying to look at different talent pools. And I like the word that Neha used, brain drain. I didn't think of it from that aspect, but what we heard in terms of brain drain many years back, which was more brain drain happening to outside of India and we losing talent to US and other geographies. If you were to look at women not returning to work or having challenges in terms of coming back to work is a real brain drain. So thank you for that addition to my vocabulary in that respect. Difficult conversations. Well, it was a difficult choice when Neha passed this mandate to share some aspects of difficult conversations. In my role in Accenture, I also have the privilege of being a trainer on negotiations. So what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to blend in couple of tenets that are there from what negotiations is and how negotiations could be used, leveraged by some of you while you're trying to work your way back in the corporate life. I'll take about 15 minutes or so. In that, I'll just leave you with appreciation of what potentially you could also look at to have a larger perspective. First of all, and for the sake of simplicity and given the time, let's just try and simplify how we are going to manage. Let's cut it into three stages. One is before you actually get to a job. Second is when you're on the table, you're discussing, detailing, and getting on the job, or getting to the offer. And the third is post. Three stages: before, on the table, after. And we'll use some tenets which will help us on the cause now. Before is the phase when you are actually making up your mind and getting onto a phase where you want to get back to work. And the most difficult conversation is a conversation that you need to have the most with the most important person in your life. And can anyone say who that person would be? Awesome. Yes. That's one difficult conversation that you need to start your life with when you're looking towards coming back. And that conversation needs to give you the boundary wall about what is it that you're looking at when you're returning back. What is the ecosystem that you will need? Who all are the stakeholders? And while I might use some jargons which are being pulled into the personal life, but look at a life in that manner. Your immediate family, your children, your extended family, in-laws, larger society, substrata of society, uncles, aunties, whosoever forms a part of your ecosystem. Your friends, family, your influencers to your family, right? But oh, khanna uncle pass wale, you know, and this and that, because you need to understand what is the frame that your family would make a decision. The second aspect is conversation, relationship. You need to leverage your relationship with your parents, your in-laws, your husband, so as to for them to reinforce your decision of coming back. How do you harness the energy in the most positive manner, so that when you have decided of coming back, how do everyone bring in the positivity and the support system and the ecosystem which will help you make successful? Once you're at that stage, what you have is you have all readiness, your preparedness of getting back to work. You have clarity of mind. You have clarity in terms of goal. What is it that you're looking towards? What is it that in terms of coming back to a corporate life? you're looking towards, and some aspects of your clarity over there will also need to use a couple of other options that I'm going to table now. Those are options and alternates. Now, these are two words that we use. Options, you're coming back to work is what you need to do. Options are, what companies would you look at? Let's say, for example, you heard Neha talk about tech jobs. You were in a tech job, then options for you would be whether I join Accenture or a IBM or a Cognizant. Those are options. You might also want to look at alternates that you might have. Well, you were in the software development side. You've been there for a while. You had a career that you had before the time you took the break. How about trying something else? In the interim that you had that tech journey, you also had appreciation of what, let's say, a L&D function does. Let's say what happens in the HR side. Let's see if there's something else that comes up as your interest. Would it be possible or would it be impactful for you to look at a career role change? So rather than going back to a tech job, would you rather look at something else? So that generation of an alternative. Once you have all these table at yourself and have taken a decision, then of course I'm not getting into the realms of talking about how do you leverage relationships. Out here, relationships would be, now we are at the table. At the table when we are looking for a job and we are looking for an offer to come by. Who are your ecosystem? Like when you were in the before stage, your family ecosystem, that was your ecosystem. Out here, the ecosystem will be your consultants in the market who are helping you build a reach, your network, past colleagues, past supervisors, past mentors that you would have worked with, and how is it that you are leveraging connects with them? How is it that you can use social media to your advantage, get connected to people through LinkedIn or by other means, and look at opportunities where you would have a fitment to what you want to do versus what opportunities are being offered by companies. That could be a difficult stage because most of the time, and what I have seen myself, my experience, is that when there is a person who's looking towards coming back, looking at rebooting their career, coming back in the workforce, I guess they leave a certain amount of readiness, preparedness, half done. And that typically is in terms of polishing up to what they want to bring to the table. Understand the starting position can be of a bias, right? While in as much as corporate world tries to do negative bias in terms of returning mothers or returning women or any other kind of biases, but it is there. The only way you can counter it, be acknowledge that and be ready to be overcoming that. Now that could be in terms of your readiness. Are you brushed up to what you had done earlier and are you up to speed? You heard Neha also talk about some of the things which is saying that some of the things that you might have worked are legacy today. The kind of pace in which the workplace is changing is very fast. It's significantly fast for us to keep. People who've been working are finding it fast to live up to that pace, and that's why you see more and more companies coming out about mental health. It is really important that we acknowledge the point that the pace of change which is happening across the industry is significantly fast. And for us to be able to keep a pace with that, we need to brace up and also invest in our own self. With that perspective, people who are wanting to come back need to work all that extra to cover that gap or bridge that gap and have a differentiator in that life. In my career, I have seen people of all kind coming back to their work and having successful careers. Successful careers could mean different things for different people. And that's where the first part of having a conversation with self is very important, which is people would be very clear that I want to go back at the same level, designation, perks, salary as I left. Well, that's a good expectation to have. That's one of the expectations to have. Some people could be more vocal about what they feel is that, okay, I acknowledge there's a break that I've taken. I've acknowledged that I have learned some life skills, which is what my priority at that point of time was. And I'm fine to get back to the track by coming back to where I would have been had I not taken this break. So I'm ready to get to the race again, and I'm okay to get a starting point and make my journey from there. Now, I've had all kind of people who've had career progression as if they had not taken those 2-3 years of interim break, and I've also had people who have come back in the same function, same role, or I've also seen people who have traversed in terms of their role, doing one role at the earlier part and now coming back into a different function. I guess it leads us to what our priority is, and in a negotiation parlance, that's what you are striving to get into a negotiations with. Negotiations is about getting what you want and traversing your way to what you want. So defining what you want is very important. And the third aspect that I want to touch upon is after. So we talked before, we talked at the table and the after. Once you have an offer and you've joined the company, I guess it's important for you to establish your credentials by virtue of putting across of what's flexible and what's inflexible to you. You have a life, you have a family, you have your ecosystem to cater to. That's what you have left. It's also important for you to acknowledge that you might need to do some additional work to be able to manage that on your own. And it's okay for you to call out at the table saying that I will need to leave at 4 o'clock. However, I can attend to any calls or mails which are there post 8 p.m. Or I will have my deliverables come across on a timely manner. While I might not be available maybe 12 to 2 when I have to go and pick my kids from school. It's fine, I guess, with today's mindset coming in. More and more people are realizing that it's important to retain talent, retain a diverse talent. And I guess the enabling environment is nurturing all those kind of thoughts. One thing that I didn't pick up, which I should have earlier, is on the part of life skills. When you go through a personal phase of attending to your needs, personal needs, family needs, starting a family, nurturing a family, or catering to something in family, you step away from learning professional skills and get down to honing your personal skills, skills which are very intrinsic to each individual. Now, it would be a big mistake if you think that those skills are not relevant in the corporate world. I think the key part is, how do you make those skills very relevant? The most important aspect to have a diverse workforce is when there is a set of people, there's a team which is together. If there's a homogeneity of idea of a singularity, which is only one directional, we will not be able to unlock the value by not having diverse thought on the table. So whether you've learned patience in terms of handling your kids, or being patient in terms of managing things at home, or multitasking 10 immediate and urgent issues going on at the personal front, or negotiating, managing 5 people in the house who all want different things. Those are skills that you need to bring to the fore, right, and try and see how relevant are they in a corporate culture. It's very important to acknowledge that the strength that you have is the strength that you need to exhibit on the table when you're at the discussion. Because that's the strength that hiring companies would like to see. That's the strength that will give you success. And that's the strength which has a lot of dependencies in terms of how ready are you in terms of coming back. Thank you.